How dare you, Space Rangers? I really cannot do an echo voice. Jurassic Park, they told you I was dead. Well, don't listen to them, because I'm not afraid of T-Rex. Yeah, that's right, guys. Today we are reviewing Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous. So, today we're reviewing Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous. It's actually like a very new show on Netflix. Like, today's Sunday, it popped up on Friday. So, yeah, I just finished watching the show yesterday. And so I figured I might as well give a review on it. Why not? So, little bit of story time before I get into the actual review. Let's start with what I think of the actual Jurassic World movies. Now, I may not look like it, but I'm actually a Jurassic Park fan. Not a die-hard fan like I am of Star Wars, where I come up with theories and stories and such. But I have watched all the movies. Hell, I even checked out the Telltale game they made way back when. And yeah, I do know more or less some of the things that go in the books. I haven't read the books, but yeah. So that seems to be it. I have watched, again, I do know a lot of Jurassic Park slash World stuff. And let me just say, it's so weird how, at least according to me, the Jurassic World trilogy is so similar to the new Star Wars sequel trilogy. Like, we have the first film in the trilogy, which is exactly the same as the film that started the whole franchise. Jurassic World is almost exactly the same as Park, so it's crazy. Just with a few changes here and there. But yeah, I would say it's different enough to be called its own movie. It's also the first Jurassic World slash Park movie I saw, so that's crazy. The second one was a disappointment among fans. And Jurassic World Dominion isn't out yet. But if it's anything like Rise of Skywalker, I can bet you it's gonna disappoint both sides of the fan base. Ooh, though an extra thing to note is that Colin Trevorrow worked on both this show, the one I'm reviewing right now, and Fallen Kingdom. And he was supposed to, and the funny fact is that he was supposed to be working on episode 9, the original episode 9, Duel of Fates. So it's crazy again how these two trilogies are so similar. Anyways, when I saw the marketing for this show, I was like, I wasn't interested in it. I was like, this seems to be a kind of dumb show, you know what I'm saying? Like a bunch of kids being selected to go to this island. So it's basically this camp, right? So it's a bunch of kids who win a contest, or through a strange set of circumstances, they are picked to go to this camp. And when they go to this camp, it's on Isla Nublar, aka Jurassic World. However, the camp is on the other side of the island, away from the park. And so, you know, what I was hearing is that this was going to be like a prequel to Jurassic World, the movie. Hijinks were going to ensue, and then we were going to see these kids survive and whatnot. So when I saw this, I was like, I'm not interested in the show. I mean, no one's going to die. These kids? Nah, man, whenever kids are the main characters of the show, you know they're never going to die. Like, at least with the movies, you expected a death here and there. So I was not looking forward to this show. I expected something very mediocre. And that's what we got for the first half of the season, before it took a complete 180 and actually became good. So let's talk about the show, shall we? Where do we start? I guess I could start with the characters, since they're easily the most, I want to say, special thing about this show. They are all almost annoying. We have Darius, our main character, who's fine. He's a dino nerd. He can get cringy at times. I'm not going to name all of them. I just want to say some of them are annoying. Some of them are just, ugh. Not all of them will grow on you by the end of the season, but I will say that some of them you will like, such as, again, Darius. Kenji, he was fine for a bit, and then he just went back to being a bully, so I don't even care. And, yeah, the other characters are fine. There's just this one girl who's obsessed with her phone, and I swear this script was written by 40-year-olds, because apparently all they know that teenagers are addicted to is phone, so I'm just gonna just lay back here and whatnot. So the characters, they're not great. The story itself is actually interesting. I thought this was going to be a prequel to the Jurassic World movie. What I didn't know was that it was actually going to take place during the Jurassic World movie. Like, I only realized this, like, in episode 5 when I saw Masrani's helicopter shooting the Indominus Rex. By the way, spoiler alert. I forgot to mention spoiler alert. This series is, like, really new. It literally only came out 2 days ago. So if you haven't watched it, go watch it, then come back. So, I literally remember the helicopter thing shooting the Indominus Rex. And I'm like, oh my god, this joins in with the movie. But no, I should have realized that in episode 4 when the Indominus Rex escaped from his cage. I don't know why I didn't say it. I thought it was just like, oh, the Indominus Rex escaped. You gotta put it back in its cage and then things will go back to normal. I don't know. So, yeah. So the story is really good. I really like how it... What the hell? I really like how it tied into the movie. Clone Wars Season 7 style. It really tied into the movie before and during the movie. Like, the last episode, I'm guessing, took place at the same time when we were having Rexy versus the Indominus Rex. So it was pretty cool again. So, yeah. The movie... I really like how it tied into the movie. I really like how it worked well, both as a prequel series and as a midquel series. The only things are just, you know, the back and forth things like, oh yeah, obviously this didn't happen during the movie. Or, oh yeah, this is weird. Of course this wouldn't have happened during the movie because, you know, they didn't plan for it. So, yeah. But the story is really good. I just wish it didn't take so long to get to the core of the story. And that's the problem with this show, is that it takes a while to start. But when it does start... Oh my god, does it start. It really does go well once everything has been put into gear and we're all ready to go and such. So, it took a while, but we got there. And then there are some pointless episodes. Like, we could have done without episode 2 and 3. I feel like we could have just removed those two. Things would have still gone the same. Yeah, I mean, some things did happen in 2, but all in all, I don't know. The first... 3 to 4 episodes were like really slow. Things only started getting good from like the halfway point. This show is only like 8 episodes long, so yeah, there's that. I guess I should talk about the animation as well, which it isn't bad. Really, the only thing I could say about it is it's above average. Like, the dinosaur models, they look fine. Some look a bit weirder than others, but it's fine. The character designs, at first, I was not on board with them, but then I grew used to them as we went along, so it's fine for what it is. I really understand why the animation looks like this, because they are adapting something live action to animation, and usually when they do that it's more of 2D style, but this one they wanted to do it 3D style, so I understand why it would look like this. It's just a bit off-putting when you're starting off the series. Like, yeah, it's a bit off, but the sooner you get used to it, the better. It really does grow on you a bit better into the series. Another thing I like to say about this show is that it at least takes some risks. The main character, Darius, I really like his growth, especially throughout here, where he loses his dad's necklace because, you know, his dad died of cancer, and he's like, oh, okay, I don't need this necklace anymore. It's, you know, we have to keep moving on. So I really like how he was able to grow and move on from that. I also like how he was able to lead the team in the final episode. I feel like his arc was the one that really shined for everyone here. Then there was like this coward, Ben. He's the coward of the group, literally afraid of everything. I thought, okay, there's a point in the show where they make it look like he's gonna die. I thought this show really had the balls to kill Ben off. But of course, I had to remind myself, he ain't really dead. And of course, in the final episode, we see that, yeah, he's not really dead. He's just, he's fine. He'll walk it off because... that's what they do. Also, they're like, there should have been like hundreds of times when this show should have, when the kids in here should have died. Like, they fall through trees, they like in water, they're being chased by creatures. I'm like, there is no way these guys are still alive. They have to be injured beyond heck. But we get a broken leg. Anyways, I don't really have a lot to say about the show. It's good for what it is. I would dare say it's even better than some of the movies, if I was to compare it to the movies. Like, I would say it's number 3 or 4 on my movie list. So it's not too bad. Though I do wish the story did start off quicker. I wish things kicked into gear quicker than they did. I wish that it didn't take so long for the story to get going. It felt a bit slow at the beginning. So, all in all, this show took a while to get started. Once it does get started, boom, you're on the right track. Again, I really loved the dino stuff, especially in the second half. They knew what they were doing. And, yeah, I really like all the people that worked on this. I didn't know Steven Spielberg and Colin Trevorrow worked on this. So, that's really cool. I really love the fact that they did that. The friendship between the characters, yeah, I guess it's... in fact, the friendship here is actually more organic than I expected. Because, like, they start off not being friends and they end up only having to work together so they can team up with each other and all. So, I really like the dynamic between these characters. I just did not like the characters themselves. So, all in all, the animation, it's passable. It's above average. I wouldn't say it's great or anything. It really doesn't grow on me. Again, the dinosaur models are fine, so I can let that go. The characters themselves, not liking it. I love the dynamic between them. I like their growing friendship. That's cool. What else can I say? The animation, again, above average. Story is good. Again, the story is really good. I really love the fact that this movie, that this series ties into the main movie. And what's so good about it is that at the end of the season, spoiler alert, they don't make it to the ferry, meaning that these kids are stuck on the island. And so now they have to wait for a rescue team to come and find them, which could take weeks for all they know. Meaning they're probably going to have to build forts and such. And what I love about this is that it doesn't have to feel restrained anymore. I felt like season one was a bit restrained for the mere fact that it's a prequel. And you know, if you're a prequel or a midquel, you are restrained because you have to follow the logic of the movie you're based on. But now, season two onwards takes place after Jurassic World, meaning they can do whatever they want to these children. And considering Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom takes place 3 years after the first movie, they can carry the show on for as long as they want, as long as they say it takes place within that 3 year time period. So yeah, maybe we'll see a cameo or something from these kids in Jurassic World Dominion. That would be hilarious if they do that. But like, I'll definitely look for Easter eggs and such. But as of now, I will say that I am hooked. The show really ended well for me. I feel like that was a good note for it to end on. And it was a real twist reveal. I really expected them to get on the ferry, go home, and then have this show be a one-season thing. Like, it just ends like that. But nope. They are sticking around for season two, and so am I guess. I'm honestly excited for what they're going to do in the future, because I really don't know what they're going to do now. Really, anything is possible at this point in time. Literally, everything is unpredictable. Now that it's no longer tied to the Jurassic World movie, because season one really was about the movie, now that it's no longer tied to the movie, they can do whatever they want, and I'm honestly quite excited to see what they come up with. So, yeah, it's crazy, because, like, as far as I'm concerned, they're like two Jurassic Park books, I think three maybe, and now all of a sudden we're having so many spin-offs and games based on those books. Like, how much depth do those books have? They must be like freaking dictionaries. So yeah, I'm gonna ride along for season two, which is, I heard, gonna come out late next year. So great, more waiting. Instead of waiting 6 months like freaking Capo and Glitch Text. God damn it, how is it those shows get a freaking second season, but this one you have to wait another bloody year? Same thing goes for Troll Hunters. Ugh. Anyways, yeah, so this show, it's good enough to stand on its own. I would say it has my not my vote, but it has my support. I'll stick around for season two. I really like the twist ending, and I honestly can't wait to see what they do forward. Now, originally, I was going to give this show a 6 out of 10, because in my eyes, it was above average. I didn't like it a lot. But now, after letting it sit for a while, I think it deserves a 7 or an 8 out of 10 around there. It's not spectacular, but I think it's good enough to hold your attention and keep you around for much more. Well, guys, I'll see you soon. I have been Captain Phoenix, T-Rex Roll, and my dear, wait, Dr. YouTube. My dear Dr. Patience, welcome to Jurassic Phoenix. I'm messing with you guys. Be sure to like and subscribe. See you all. Love ya. I've been Captain Phoenix, and I'll see you in another universe.